What's up everyone, Tony here, and today we are going to take a look at the locations for each and every single purple Spiritomb Wisp in Pokemon Legends Arceus. To complete request number 22, Eerie Apparitions in the Night, we are asked to go out and find a whopping 107 Wisps. They are scattered across the game's 6 unique maps. 20 can be found at each of the big maps, plus an additional 7 in Jubilife Village. It's definitely a time-consuming process, but if you want a Spiritomb, you're gonna have to complete this challenge. And you'll need a Spiritomb if you want to complete the Pokedex and get to Arceus, so you're gonna have to collect every Wisp sooner or later if you want to 100% the game. Luckily, if you find this kind of collecting tedious, today's video should help you crank out any Wisps you missed in a timely fashion. We'll go area by area, collecting them all, and I even placed the Wisps in a logical order based on location, so it's easier for you to travel from one to the next quickly. Let's not waste any more time and get right into it, all 107 Wisp locations in Pokemon Legends Arceus. First things first, I highly recommend finishing the main game before attempting to tackle this request. I don't think it's even possible to collect every Wisp without Sneasler's climbing ability or Braviary's flight. Also, looking for Wisps at nighttime makes them far more visible from a distance compared to daytime, so go to your camp and switch to nighttime before you go Wisp hunting. With those tips out of the way, it's time to begin our search. We'll go area by area, checking Wisps off our list. Let's begin with Obsidian Fieldlands, where 20 of them can be found. The first one can be found very close to the entrance of this area, just a short distance southwest. From there, head south to this area near Lake Verity for the next Wisp. Next, we head east outside of the Lake Verity area to find a Wisp beside the river. Head south and the next Wisp can be found on this small island near Windswept Run. Head west and the next Wisp is found here in Sand Gem Flats. The next Wisp can be found at the southern part of Ramanas Island. From there, head south to the very tip of the map here, and a Wisp can be found right beside an Alpha Lopunny. Head directly east and you'll quickly come across yet another Wisp along this southern edge of the map. Continue east towards the Heartwood to find yet another Wisp. As we finally begin heading back north, you'll find another Wisp at this spot here. Head north up to the eastern tip of the map and we'll find another Wisp at this area where a bunch of Machop and Machoke are wandering around. Continue north and another Wisp can be found on this little island near Obsidian Falls. The next Wisp can be found here near the northeast tip of the map. From there, head west, and the next Wisp can be found near the gigantic Alpha Rapidash. We'll finish up Obsidian Fieldlands by heading south and cleaning up all the Wisps found in the central area of the map. This one is found right near Warren Bridge. Head west towards Deer Track Path to find the next one right here. From there, we had Self, and the next Wisp could be found right here. Head east, and the next Wisp could be found all the way at the top of the mountain here, near your camp. Go south, and the next Wisp could be found here, near Nature's Pantry. And finally, head east, and we can find our 20th and final Wisp from Obsidian Fieldlands right here. Good job! Now it's time to move on to our next area of the game. Our first Wisp in the Crimson Mirelands can be found here, just a short distance south of our camp. From there, we head east towards the river to find the next Wisp. Head south to Gapejaw Bog to find the next Wisp right here. Continue south to find the next Wisp right here. Now we head east along the bottom of the map to find a Wisp near Home of Trials. Continue east and we'll find a Wisp here being guarded by this horrifying Alpha Sligoo. We go further east to find a Wisp here, south of Ursa's Ring. Now we head northeast to look along the east side of the map, and we can find a Wisp right here. Head north and we can find a Wisp here on the other side of the river near Cottonsedge Prairie. Now we can head directly east from there to find a Wisp at Cottonsedge Prairie, right here. Very close by, we can find another Wisp right here. Travel west to the other side of the river to find a Wisp here at Boulder Roll Slope. Now we head north towards Lake Valor, and we can find a Wisp right here. Next, we go northwest to Shrouded Ruins, and we find a Wisp here. Go slightly west and we can find another Wisp very close by. Continue west and we can find another Wisp on this cliff right near the river at Cloudpool Ridge. Head south from there and we find another Wisp even closer to the river. Next, we go east towards the middle of the map and can find a Wisp here near Diamond Settlement. From there, we head south and find the next Wisp right here. And finally, we could head towards Salacian Ruins to find the 20th and final Wisp in Crimson Mirelands. With 40 wisps in hand, it's time to head to the next area. To begin here in Cobalt Coastlands, the first wisp can be found just steps away from our camp, right here. From there, we head south to Crossing Slope to find the next wisp, right here. Continue south and we can find another wisp on this mountain here. A few steps east from there, we can find another wisp on the water here. From there, head directly south to the bottom of the map, and a wisp can be found on this tiny island. Head east, and another wisp can be found at another tiny island at Tombolo Walk. Head northwest, and yet another wisp can be found at yet another tiny island right here. Next, we go directly east, and another wisp can be found at the tip of the land, right here. As we head towards the north side of the map, we can grab a wisp at this small island located at the center of the map. From there, head west back to the shore, and we can find another wisp right here. Head back east towards Castaway Shore. Climb up the cliffside, and you'll find a wisp right here. Climb up the mountain, and you'll find another wisp just a short distance north. Now climb down the other side of the cliff to find another wisp right here. From there, head all the way to the western tip of the map near Spring Path to find another wisp. The next wisp could be found if we head a short distance east at this spot here. Head to the northern tip of the map, and we can find another wisp right here. Now we head east to the water, and the next wisp can be found on this tiny island here. Another tiny island, another wisp, this time all the way at the northeast tip of the map. From there, head south, and the next wisp could be found on this tiny island near Firespit Island. And finally, wisp number 20 can be found at Firespit Island itself, beside some lava, at this spot right here. That's three areas down, three to go. Next, we'll head over to Coronet Highlands. We can find the first wisp right here, a short distance northeast from our camp. The next wisp could be found inside Wayward Cave. Unfortunately, I can't really show the exact location from the map screen, so you're just gonna have to explore the cave and find it yourself. Luckily, the big glowy purple ball in the dark brown cave is pretty hard to miss. Head back outside the cave and head up. Atop the waterfall beside Wayward Cave, you'll find another wisp. Head to the southern tip of the map to find another wisp right here beside the water. Next wisp can be found in this cave located near Wayward Wood right here. Head inside and climb up these slabs of granite or whatever to collect the wisp. After exiting the cave, head west to find our next wisp. Continue west to Fabled Spring and you'll find another wisp right here beside this tree. From there, head northwest to Boulder Roll Ravine. Avoid the gravelers and golems trying to murder you, and you can collect a wisp right here. Head a short distance east, and you'll find another wisp right beside the water. Continue east, and you'll find the next wisp on this cliffside right here. From there, head further east to Sonorous Path to find the next wisp right here. A short distance northeast will take you to the next wisp located right here. Head all the way to the eastmost point on the map, just to the right of Clambercaw Cliffs, to find the next wisp. Time to head in the opposite direction. Go northwest to this spot beside Clambercaw Cliffs for the next wisp. Continue west to this area beside the Sacred Plaza for another wisp. From there, a very short distance southwest will take you to the next wisp. Head west for our next wisp located right here. You guessed it, we're still heading west. Go to this spot and beside the gravestone, you'll find another wisp. From there, we head directly north to this area and Moonview Arena to find another wisp. And finally, head a short distance east to find the final wisp from this area overlooking the Sacred Plaza. That is 80 wisps down, and the finish line is in sight. Let's head to the final major area of the game to scoop another 20. Our first wisp in Alabaster Icelands is just a short flight east from our starting area camp. From there, we can head west to the other side of Whiteout Valley for our next Wisp. A short distance north will take us to our next Wisp, located right here. Fly west to find the next one, located here. Continue west to Avalanche Slopes, and the next Wisp can be found at the top of this hill beside an Alolan Vulpix. From there, we head south to find the next Wisp right here. Now we head north to this area near Arena's Approach to find the next one right here. Head a short distance east to find the next Wisp right here. From there, a short distance north will bring you to the next Wisp. Now we head east to the center of the map. Near Bonechill Wastes, we'll have to head underground. Towards the back of the cave, you'll come across a Hisuian Zorua, and beside it, a Wisp for you to collect. Once you're back above ground, you'll find the next Wisp just a short distance east. Next, we head north to find the next Wisp at Avalug's Legacy at the top of this iceberg. Head east to find the next Wisp located here. And even further east, you'll find the next one here. Now we head north, and at the Pearl Settlement, you'll find the next Wisp behind one of the tents. Next, we go west to find the next Wisp beside the waterfall at Lake Acuity. Head southwest down and to the other side of the waterfall to this spot. You'll find the secret hollow cave, and inside, another Wisp. From there, we head to Glacier Terrace to find a Wisp beside some trees. To finish off this map, head northeast to Snowpoint Temple. First, we find a Wisp outside of the temple at this spot here. And the final Wisp for Alabaster Icelands can be found inside Snowpoint Temple. This is another one where I can't really show you the location on the map, but just explore the temple and look for the bright purple glowing ball. I promise you, it's not that hard to find. There it is, 100 wisps down. All that's left is to clean up the final 7 in Jubilife Village and catch that Spiritomb. There are only 7 wisps to find in Jubilife Village, but you collect the first one immediately after being given the quest by Vessa. So really, we only have 6 more to collect in Jubilife Village. For the next one, head all the way south to the water, and you'll see a wisp nearby to collect. Head north, and the next wisp can be found here in the alleys behind these houses. The next one could be found hiding at the western tip of the map, right here. We can find a wisp right here, behind this building and beside the river. Next one could be found behind the training grounds building at the northwest tip of the map. And last but certainly not least, wisp number 107 could be found behind the Galaxy Hall building. Congratulations! If you stuck with me this far, you have collected all 107 wisps in Pokemon Legends Arceus. Well done. Now we can speak to Vessa, who gave us this whole mission in the first place. She'll give you some pretty useful items for collecting the wisps, but most important of all, she'll ask you to go meet her at Shrouded Ruins in the Crimson Mirelands at night to finish this quest once and for all. Go to the cracked rock thing to trigger a cutscene with Vessa. She'll ask you to collect the final wisp, and once you do, you'll officially complete the Eerie Apparitions in the Night request. At that moment, a level 60 Spiritomb will spawn right behind you. It's finally time to catch this thing. Luckily, that's not too difficult. All I did was put it to sleep and chucked 2 Ultra Balls at it and was able to successfully catch it at full health. In case you fail or cause the Spiritomb to faint, you should be able to return to this spot and the Spiritomb will respawn. And with that, we are going to wrap it up for today. I hope this video was able to help you find some of those trickier wisps. Again, congratulations on collecting the Pokemon Legend Arceus equivalent of Breath of the Wild Korok Seeds. It's quite the time-consuming process. In fact, making this video nearly killed me. But hey, with Spiritomb in hand, you're one step closer to finishing that Pokedex and getting to Arceus, so I guess it's worth it. If you like this video and want to see more Pokemon Legends Arceus guides and content, please hit that like button and subscribe to my channel. I still have a bunch of other videos in the works, so definitely look forward to those coming very soon. But until next time, thanks so much for watching, everyone, and take care.